Hello, this is Bern, and if you've been going for the kind of man who's ultra achieving and super confident and very ambitious, and you're not finding the resonance that you're seeking, something's not clicking. On today's video, I'm gonna answer the question, should you go for an alpha male? And if not, who should you go for instead? Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to another edition of BernMendez.com. A space where I share with ambitious and conscious women how you can attract the man you want without the need for gimmicks and manipulation. Now, if you've been struggling to enter a passionate relationship and connect with a quality man, and you wanna go deeper than what this video today will allow for, then I invite you to click on the first link in the description of this video. You'll see a page that looks like this, and access my free training that can take you deeper than what I can share in these few minutes. Let's get started with the meat of this whole thing. What is an alpha male and should you go for one? Well, there's qualities in an alpha male that are pretty attractive to most women, especially feminine women. And what are those qualities? Well, he's gonna be a guy who's more ambitious, who's confident, who can make things happen. He's more dominant in nature, which is some level of appeal. He's more aggressive also, and not necessarily aggressive with you, but aggressive in making sure that he can get what he needs to thrive in life. So there's definitely an appeal to that. What's the downside to this? Well, some of the qualities that you may not be excited about in an alpha male are, he's gonna be more selfish. He's gonna be more demanding. He's gonna be more zero-sum mentality. Zero-sum meaning like, if you're winning, he's losing. And if he's winning, you're losing. There's like only so much to the pie in his mind. More inflexible and more brain versus heart connected. Now, what's the problem with this? Well, if you go for what you subconsciously think you want, which is a guy who has, he's aggressive and getting what he wants and he's high achiever, but he also has some of his faults, then he's gonna be kind of guy who's gonna be more likely to tell you what you have to do, who has little time for you because his highest priority is making his career progress and making things happen there, maybe unable to feel you. So the problem sometimes is that you're fighting with evolution and with what society has told you you should want in your life. Here's why. Because imagine that thousands of years ago, the type of guy who could provide safety for you and for your children was the kind of guy who's more likely to kill the other men, who's likely to go and hunt and bring back the hunt early on, who's stronger, who's more aggressive. That type of guy was thriving thousands of years ago, and through evolution, you've learned in some way to go for that type of guy. Now, the problem in 2021 is that if you don't take into account that some of those guys are going to be lousy partners, then you might go for, on paper, what you think is awesome, but feel there's some level of emptiness in your life and not really understand it, because your friends tell you, hey, you have an amazing guy, he's tall and handsome and he's a hard worker and he makes things happen, but you're not feeling seen or heard or understood or felt or even adored. The problem with fighting with evolution is that you need to be able to redefine for yourself what is it that you really want. So the question, instead of should you go for an alpha male, that I'll put to you right now is, what do you really want to experience? What's the level of partnership? What's the level of connection? What's the balance in life that you're seeking that would help you choose more specifically one guy or the other one? So in other words, what are you willing to trade in order to get the depth and meaning that you really want? Why is this important? Because you might have to trade a guy who's 3 inches shorter but maybe is more emotionally intelligent. You might have to trade a guy who's slightly less ambitious for a guy who has a more open heart and time for family. You might want to trade a guy who's not an ultra achiever of the kind that works 100 hours a week, but has time to hear you out when you're struggling and when your heart is sad and when you want to have a conversation about things that have nothing to do with career and business. So there's always a trade-off in going for what you really want. And my contention to you right now, my plea, is that you evaluate what is the type of partnership that you need, and more than what you need, also what the world needs today. Because if you think about it, think about the kind of partner that your maybe grandma was able to have 50, 60 years ago, and think about the kind of partner your mom was able to have, and think about what you're seeking. My hypothesis is that as evolution has taken place, you want a lot more that what your grandma wanted or expected out of a partnership. You want a best friend, you want a confidant, you want a guy who is your playmate, you want a guy who's your lover, you want a guy who's also kind and tender, you want a guy who's able to maybe climb trees as powerfully as he can change diapers. And the problem with a guy who's purely alpha is that the qualities of open-heartedness and understanding will not be there in the way that you might need them. Am I saying that all women should want a guy like I'm describing? No, but I'm saying the vast majority of women I've had conversations with have fallen for the trap of going for on paper resume type of analogy of a guy instead of a guy who absolutely understands them and helps them thrive in a partnership. So what are some of the things you should look for in a guy? Am I saying you should look for a guy who is just clueless and lost in life and not ambitious and not have a career? No. What I'm saying is that you should balance the leadership qualities in a man and his sense of purpose, which is absolutely important and something I highly recommend. Leadership and sense of purpose with kindness, with empathy, with humility, with compassion. Because if those traits are not there, if he's the type of guy who's willing to get what he wants at any cost, he will act the same way in the relationship and he will be the boss of you. And you may feel weak in the knees at the beginning, but you will definitely not like it down the road. So you want a guy who's masculine, but also has the capacity to understand you and feel you. And yeah, maybe he makes a little bit less than the other guy you were going for. Maybe he's not as tall, but maybe he's a guy who can sustain this whole package of awesomeness with you for years and years and years to come. Now, I hear the complaint from women, well, Burton, I can't change who I like. So I'm stuck with this type of guy. And here's what I have to say to you. If you grew up with parents who fed you sodas and milkshakes and burgers as your primary nutrition, and that's what you like, there's something to be said about you being able to, A, understand that if you continue eating that way, you might have a heart attack by 50, and nutrition will not be what it needs to be, but also that you can develop a different palate. You can taste Korean food and Indian food and French food and lo and behold sushi, and you might really enjoy it. You might be able to trade some of those French fries for California rolls at some point in your life, but not if you don't start. So I never an advocate for you to enter a relationship that lacks passion and excitement. I am a proponent of balancing the passion and the excitement with sustainability and heart and depth and meaning and some of the values that will last through years and decades versus the initial pull that may draw you further and further apart from him. If you like what I shared with you, I'm gonna ask you to do one thing, to take this deeper and to understand how to enter the relationship you want. Go to the first link to the description of this video, enter in an email, and start watching my free training right away. If you like this video, please click like or thumbs up. Share with me a comment. Tell me what you liked and what you enjoyed or what you are not understanding about this. And subscribe to my channel so you can be notified of new episodes as they come out. And last but not least, if you've been struggling with love and with companionship and with relationships for a while, and you've been watching videos and reading books and doing the law of attraction and mantras and yoga and the whole thing, and you're not getting it, you might highly benefit from having someone help you and guide you and hold your hand through the way. And that, if you think that might be me, there's a second link on the description of this video that will allow you to apply to work together. And if we're a fit, we'll have a conversation and I'll share with you what the work looks like and how it can help you. Thank you so much for connecting with me. Thank you so much for allowing me into your heart, into your home, into your cell phone. And as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.